tub took up part of the first floor. Police and regular customers say there were counters where female workers could talk with customers as they ate and drank. The second floor of the building was used exclusively by the maid cafe. The second floor had 7 rooms on both sides of a passageway. Someone uploaded a picture of the cafe on Twitter. Many customers say it is the second floor passageway. And there was a room called the King Room, where people could sing karaoke and play games with employees they asked for by name. And there were other rooms where customers could talk with employees one-on-one. One regular customer says everyone enjoyed each other's company, and the atmosphere was like that of Akihabara in Tokyo. He says lots of first-timers and regular customers came to the cafe. Police say all the people who died appear to have been in the same room on the second floor. Investigators say the garbage disposal area near the entrance of the building on the southwest side was especially badly burned. Used oil from a kitchen and cardboard had reportedly been placed at the disposal site. Police say one worker told them he or she noticed the fire on the way down from the second floor. Past fires in tenanted buildings in entertainment districts have killed many people. In 2001, a fire broke out near a staircase landing in a building in Kabukicho, in Tokyo's Shinjuku ward. The fire spread, killing 44 people, including tenant employees and customers. In 2008, a man started a fire on the first floor of a building in Osaka's Naniwa ward, killing 16 people. The floor housed booths for viewing DVDs. Professor Kyoichi Kobayashi of a graduate school at Tokyo University of Science is an expert on fire prevention. Kobayashi says various tenants need to contact one another and work together if a fire breaks out. But he says it's difficult for them to hold joint drills and pass information to one another. He says sounds from karaoke and sound insulation make hearing difficult. He says that's why people in tenanted buildings cannot easily detect fires. Police plan to conduct another on-site investigation tomorrow to determine where and how the fire started.
A record torrential rain caused enormous damage to many areas of the Kanto and Tohoku regions last month. It's been 1 month since a bank of the Kinugawa River in Jōsō City, Ibaraki Prefecture, collapsed. While the effort to restore the area is gradually making progress, the magnitude of the damage to agricultural businesses that support the region's economy has come to light. This elementary school suffered heavy damage. Today, new textbooks were distributed to children whose textbooks were drenched or swept away when the area suffered from the torrential rain. This boy says he's happy to receive the new books. He says it hasn't been easy to study with photocopies of the textbooks. Tomorrow marks 1 month since the bank of the Kinugawa River broke in the torrential rain that hit the Kanto and Tohoku regions. A reporter says that even today many houses are left collapsed or slanting. More than 400 people in Ibaraki Prefecture have been forced to live in evacuation centers. This woman says she wants to go home as soon as possible as she feels unsettled. This man says he thinks nothing has changed except it's become colder compared to the time he came here. This is a glasses shop. NHK reported on the shop immediately after the rains. Many garbage bags could be seen in front of the shop, and cleanup work is still underway inside the shop. An NHK reporter first came to the shop soon after the water subsided. Glasses that had been displayed in showcases were covered with mud. The optician Toshiki Nozaki says he's kept all these glasses in boxes. Equipment used to adjust the glasses was also damaged. Nozaki has been cleaning inside the shop every day, but he does not know yet when he can reopen the shop. Nozaki says he cannot think about the future. He cannot reopen his shop under present conditions. He says he's so tired that all... Agriculture is a key industry in this region. You can still see traces of the damage caused by the broken embankment. Mitsuyoshi Ida is a farmer. His farm is near the bank that collapsed. He was growing rice, soybeans and wheat on 100 hectares of farmland, but most of the farmland was inundated. He says his farm has been totally destroyed. Massive mud and debris were left after the water subsided. The total amount of damage is estimated to be tens of millions of yen. Ida says the damage is so enormous that he has no idea how much he has lost. The biggest trouble facing him is the depth of mud that covers his farmland. The mud contains gravel and stones. He has to remove them so his farm machines and implements will not be damaged. He would usually be busy harvesting crops at this time of year. This year, he has no prospects of earning an income and has to pay back loans on his agricultural equipment. Ida says he just feels depressed and doesn't know what to do. He says he does not know what he should do first or even how to go about it.
The restoration work has been slow, but some owners are working to make a comeback. One brewery owner shows us the alcohol that was damaged. Kazuo Nomura's sake brewery dates back over 100 years to the Meiji period. The brewery and its vicinity were inundated, wiping out nearly 20,000 bottles of its product that were just about to be shipped out. The most devastating loss was the flooding of the room where the rice malt was made. Nomura says it was shocking because the room is the most important place when making sake. Nomura was in a state of deep depression when volunteers came to help him clean up the brewery. People from other breweries pitched in. Countless people cooperated, and today Nomura is looking forward to the final preparations for this year's new sake next month. Tonight, Nomura took part in an event in Tokyo to showcase sake brewed in Ibaraki Prefecture. He thanked other brewers that came all the way to the event. He went to each brewery that helped him out to express his gratitude. Participants were served some of Nomura's sake that managed to escape the flood. This woman says the sake is delicious, so she hopes it will sell well again once they are in production once more. This event participant says he would like to brew breweries that were damaged in the flood. Nomura says he's been able to rebuild because the people encouraged him, so he believes he will be able to produce sake in the depression. Not only his sake, his own sake, but everyone else's sake.
Well, it's been a month since the big flood, however, nothing much has changed. And the